The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hello my dear children, how are you all? I hope all are safe at home. We met 2-3 weeks before, isn't it? Because of this pandemic situation, we all are suffering. But don't worry, my dear children, we will overcome this situation very soon. I know that you all are in a celebration mood. Our Onam is coming nearby. Thiruvonappulare than Thirumul kaazha kaanan Thirumuttam aninjorungi. എല്ലാവരും ഒരുങ്ങിയോ ഓണത്തിനായിട്ട്? അപ്പോൾ ഈ ഓണത്തിൻ്റെ ഈ സെലിബ്രേഷൻ മൂഡിൽ നമുക്ക് കുറച്ച് സയൻസ് പഠിക്കാം. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ ശേഷം യു ക്യാൻ സെലിബ്രേറ്റ് ദിസ് ഓണം വിത്ത് യുവർ ഫാമിലി മെമ്പേഴ്സ്. റെഡി അല്ലേ? ഓക്കെ, ലെറ്റ്സ് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് അവർ ന്യൂ ചാപ്റ്റർ, ചാപ്റ്റർ 3. സോ അവർ തേർഡ് ലെസൺ ഈസ് ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓൾ എ സൈക്കിൾ. സോ ദ ബിഗ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഈസ് ഹൗ ഡു ബേബീസ് ബിക്കം അഡൽസ്? ഹൗ ഡു ബേബീസ് ബിക്കം adults? So overview of this lesson. In this lesson we will understand the importance of reproduction in animals, learn about the life cycles of different animals, explore the similarities and differences between the life cycles of different animals. Okay, so let's do a pep activity, that is pep activity 3.1. Read the given information on Olive Ridley turtles and answer the questions that follow. The Olive Ridley sea turtles are one of the oldest living group of animals on planet Earth. They have been around for several thousands of years. These turtles are omnivorous. They eat jellyfish, crabs, snails, shrimp, a variety of fish and some water plants. So these turtles are omnivorous. So their favorite food are jellyfish, crabs, snails, shrimp, variety of fishes and some water plants. See the picture of a cycle here. Female turtles lay eggs in sand burrows at the beach. After 45 to 60 days, the eggs hatch and turtle babies emerge and crawl towards the ocean. So they are laying eggs. They are laying eggs at the burrows which they are making at the beach. So in the beach area we can see this process. Okay, so these turtles have been around for several thousand of years. However, they are slowly starting to disappear now. Some reasons for the sudden decrease in their numbers are provided as picture clues for you. Describe what you see in the space provided. See what the man is doing there. Yes, that man is taking turtle's eggs from the burrow. Next picture. What that turtle is eating? Yes, that turtle is eating plastic. It has mistaken it for a jellyfish. It is thinking that it's a jellyfish and it is eating. Okay. And the third picture, that is a turtle is caught in a net. Form pairs and discuss your responses. Also answer the following questions by discussing with your partner. First question, what would happen to these animals if they continue to decrease in numbers?
Obviously, they will soon disappear from Earth. Second question, how do you think the turtles increase in numbers? Answer is by reproducing, that is laying more eggs. Third one, suggest two ways by which we can prevent these turtles from dying. Answer, take effort to protect and conserve these turtles and their eggs. Prevent hunting or poaching of turtles and their eggs. Clear?
So from this activity, we came to know that all these animals reproduce to continue their existence on Earth. So such type of reproduction process, we will go in detail in this lesson. So one more question is there, that is, how do young ones come into the world? How do these young ones are coming into our world? So for that, a process is there, that is reproduction. So what is reproduction? Reproduction is the process by which living things produce young ones of their own kind. So reproduction is a process of producing young ones of their own kind. Okay, the young one of an animal is known as its offspring. So young one in enda paraya, offspring. Okay, offspring nana paraya. So the reproduction is a process by which the living things produce young one of their own, and these young ones are known as offsprings. Clear? Yes.
See the activity 3.2. Figure 1 shows images of some animals and their offspring. Can you identify them? Fill in the blanks with the name of the animal and its offspring. One has been done for you. So the first one is swan and cygnet. So what is the second one? Rhinoceros and calf. Third one, gorilla and infant. And fourth one, panda and cub. Next picture is pig and piglets. And the last one is snail and baby snail. So these are the animals and their offspring. Compare each offspring to its parent. How are the young ones similar to their parents? How are they different? So the similarities, they are the shape and parts of body of the young ones are similar to their parents. The shape and the body parts of the young ones are similar to their parents. Movement, food habits and place of living of young ones and their parents are similar. See the difference? The young ones are smaller than the parents. Unlike their parents, the young ones cannot able to take care of themselves. So you have to write it there.
Mostly, these animals reproduce their young ones in two ways. There are two common ways of reproducing. One is by laying eggs, and another way is giving birth to young ones. So let's see that. Page number 64, you just go through the content. Many animals reproduce by laying eggs. These female animals are laying eggs. Okay. Birds, fishes, insects, and even reptiles such as turtles, snakes, lizard, alligator, and crocodiles usually reproduce by laying eggs. Pivarokke eggs lay cheyidittana reproduction nadakkunnathu. Edakya birds, fishes, insects, reptiles. Edakke reptiles? Turtles, snakes, lizards, alligators and crocodiles. They are usually reproduced by laying eggs. Clear? Next, the birds usually build a nest and lay their eggs in them. This you already know. Le pakshigale koodu kooti aa kootilana muttayidunnathu. Le next, fishes and frogs lay their eggs in water. If fishes and frogs in water lana eggs lay cheyanathu. Whereas reptiles such as crocodiles and olive ridley turtles usually lay their eggs in burrows. We turtles and crocodiles okke burrows lana eggs lay cheyanathu. Okay, next, once laid, the eggs of many animals require warmth to help them grow well and hatch. In such cases, the mother protects the eggs and keeps them warm. Egg lay cheythal mathram madiyo illa ee egg ne അത് എങ്ങണ്ണായിട്ട് പ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യാൻ കുറച്ച് സമയം പിടിക്കും അല്ലേ അപ്പോൾ അത്രയും സമയം അത് വാം കണ്ടീഷനിൽ വേണം ഇരിക്കാൻ സോ ഹൂ ഈസ് ഹാച്ചിങ് ദർ യെസ് ദ മദർ മദർ ഈസ് ഹാച്ചിങ് ദ എഗ്സ് ആൻഡ് കീപ് ദ എഗ്സ് വാം ഓക്കെ This process is known as incubation. അതിനെ ചൂടോടെ സംരക്ഷിക്കണം. So this process is known as incubation. അപ്പോൾ ഈ പ്രോസസ്സിനെയാണ് ഇൻക്യുബേഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. An example of an animal that incubates its eggs is a bird. Most birds sit on their eggs to keep them warm. Snakes coil around their eggs to keep them warm. After the incubation period, the offspring hatches from the egg. ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ ഇൻക്യുബേഷൻ പീരീഡ് കഴിഞ്ഞ് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഈ ഓഫ്സ്പ്രിങ്സ് ആ മുട്ട പൊട്ടിച്ച് പുറത്തേക്ക് വരുന്നു ഓക്കെ അണ്ടർസ്റ്റുഡ് യെസ് നൗ വിൽ ഗോ ത്രൂ ദ ആക്ടിവിറ്റി 3.3 ആക്ടിവിറ്റി 3.3 റീഡ് ദ പോയം ആൻഡ് ആൻസർ ദ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ യുവർ അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡിങ് ഓഫ് ദ പോയം Some animal babies from the animal kingdom formed a club based on how they came from their mom. These included calves of yaks, cows and camels, little playful donkey foals, cubs of cheetahs, walruses and a bear, pups of dogs and fawns of a mare, a cute piglet, goat kids and kittens of a cat, jaws of a kangaroo, Wallaby and a wombat. Baby animals from far and near found similar qualities among their peers that within their mother's body they developed and grew. They weren't laid in the form of an egg, rather given birth to. So, based on this, the first question is, why do you think all the animals in the poem decided to form a club? The answer is the animals formed a club because all of them developed inside their mother's bodies and were given birth to. Second question, name a few more animals that can join the club. Elephants, lions, tigers, monkeys, dolphins and other such animals can join the club. Third question, do you think human belong to this club? Why or why not? Yes, humans belong to the club because human babies also develop inside their mother's bodies and are given birth to. Next question, name three animals that cannot join this club. Why? Turtles, crocodiles, frogs or other such animals that reproduce by laying eggs cannot join this club. Okay, so we'll go to the next way of reproduction, that is giving birth to young ones. So see page number 66. The young ones of some animals grow inside the mother's body for a certain period of time. Le, for a certain period of time ile ee young ones mother-inte body ile irikkum. So once they are able to survive in this earth, they are coming out. So this mother is giving birth, isn't it? Yes. So the animals that give birth to young ones and secrete milk to feed their young are called mammals ല്ലേ നമ്മൾ മനുഷ്യരൊക്കെ അങ്ങനെയല്ലേ കുട്ടികൾ കറക്റ്റ് ആ ഒരു പീരീഡ് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ആയി കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ അവർക്ക് ഭൂമിയിലേക്ക് വരാൻ പറ്റും ല്ലേ നയൻ മന്ത്സ് ആഫ്റ്റർ നയൻ മന്ത്സ് ദേ ആർ കമ്മിങ് ഔട്ട് സോ ദിസ് മദർ ഈസ് റെഡി ടു ഫീഡ് ദം സോ ദിസ് ബേബി ഈസ് ഡ്രിങ്കിങ് ദ മിൽക്ക് ഫ്രം ദ mother it is always the female animal that gives birth to young ones and feed them so as usual the female animals are giving birth to the young ones okay elephants dolphins lions whales and monkeys are few examples of mammals in edakke examples yes elephants dolphins lions whales and monkeys okay See here one green box is there in your studio. There are rare cases where mammals lay eggs. Their young ones hatch from eggs but drink milk from their mother. Such animals are called monotremes. The duck-billed platypus and the echidnae, spiny ant eater, are the only examples of monotremes. എന്താണപ്പോൾ ഈ മോണോട്രീംസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് അത് റെയർ കേസസ് മാമൽസിലുള്ള റെയർ കേസസ് ആണ് അവർ എഗ്സ് ലേ ചെയ്യും യങ് വൺസ് ഹാച്ച് ഫ്രം ദ എഗ്സ് ബട്ട് ഡ്രിങ്ക് മിൽക്ക് ഫ്രം ദെയർ മദർ അങ്ങനെയുള്ളവരെ മോണോട്രീംസ് എന്നാണ് പറയുന്നത് ഓക്കെ So the young ones are much smaller in size compared to an adult. Le, ammeda athra thanne valippu undavo kuttikalkku illa. So the young ones are very tiny, isn't it? Yes, they need care and guidance from adults till they grow enough to take care of themselves. Avare avare thanne നോക്കാൻ അവരുടെ കാര്യങ്ങളെല്ലാം തനിയെ ചെയ്യാൻ പ്രാപ്തരാവുന്നത് വരെ ആരുടെ ഗൈഡൻസ് ആവശ്യമുണ്ട് യെസ് ദേ നീഡ് ദ ഗൈഡൻസ് ഓഫ് ദെയർ മദർ ഓക്കെ നൗ വിൽ ഡു അനദർ ആക്ടിവിറ്റി ആക്ടിവിറ്റി 3.4 വി ഹാവ് നൗ ലേൺഡ് എബൌട്ട് ദ ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് വേയ്സ് ഇൻ വിച്ച് ആനിമൽസ് റീപ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് കമ്പയർ ആൻഡ് കോൺട്രാസ്റ്റ് ദ ക്യാരക്ടറിസ്റ്റിക്സ് ഓഫ് ദ യങ് വൺസ് ഇൻ ഫിഗർ 3 ഇൻ ദ ബ്ലൂ സ്പേസ് Describe the young ones of egg-laying animals. In the yellow space, describe the young ones of animals that give birth. In the green space, where the circles overlap, fill in the characteristics that are common to both types of young ones. So, in the blue space, young ones that hatch from eggs. So, you have to write young ones develop inside the egg before they hatch. Next sentence, some eggs need to be incubated before hatching le before hatching incubation is the process going on le ennale adu nalla aarogyulla kunjungalayitte porthu varullu and in the yellow region you have to write young ones that are given birth to answer is young ones develop inside their mother's body for a certain period of time next sentence mothers feed babies with their milk till they learn to look after themselves and the point where the both are overlapping that is that dark green area both types of young ones resemble their parents the mother brings the young ones into the world by laying eggs or giving birth some young ones are looked after by their parents when young okay so from all these activities we came to know that without reproduction animals will continue to reduce in numbers and eventually they disappear from earth le reproduction nadannillengi enda pattya all animals or birds they will disappear from the earth so the reproduction is a necessary factor for the living thing isn't it so for their existence this reproduction is an inevitable factor clear So now you can identify the ways in which animals reproduce. Analyze the similarities and differences between the young ones of egg-laying animals and mammals. Clear? So we studied two types of reproduction here. One is laying eggs, isn't it? Laying eggs, hatching, and young ones are coming out. Next one, that is giving birth to young ones and feeding them and giving proper guidance till they are able to care by themselves. Yes, is it clear? So with this small topic, we are going to wind up our class today. So you have to read the content well, do the activity, and I will be coming soon. Okay, bye.